So, age associated hypogonadism does not develop in men the way it develops in women. So, andropause is not a timely diagnosis. Right? The decline is very, very gradual. Like in menopause, it is sudden, gone is gone. So, therefore, andropause again itself is whether it should be taken as a clinical entity or not is debatable. And from there, this word had come, partial androgen deficiency in adult male. Partial androgen deficiency in adult male. So this is the word which has replaced andropause actually. And the association of low testosterone to well-being was clearly shown by one data analysis where it was shown that if the testosterone is on a lower side, then the chances of those people to die of coronary artery disease or other metabolic issues were actually much, much more over the period of next 20 years compared to the people who had optimum testosterone. So here is about Padam, partial androgen deficiency in adult male. Now the question is how to diagnose androgen deficiency or testo deficiency. So there are two criteria you can take. One is biochemical criteria and one is clinical criteria. The best is both together. Kya hota hai, if you go only to the biochemical criteria and just doing the blood test randomly, so you may find somebody having low testosterone in the blood sample but actually having no symptom of it. With this, you will be diagnosing more and more people of having hypogonadism. Right? When you go with the only clinical criteria, so the symptom of androgen deficiency actually overlaps with lot of other issues. Simple stress, financial issues, interpersonal problem in the family, what all I was discussing before. So that may be a reason of the symptom and you can attribute it only to testosterone deficiency and which may, so therefore you have to mix both of them. So go with clinical, see the biochemical. If biochemical is showing absolutely down, I mean to say less than 200 or 150, then your mind is made up. I am going to give testo either directly or boosting testo as depending upon the LH in that young patient. Okay? In old, so you are in any way going to get. Done? The same thing. So here, lethargy, reduced concentration, sleep disturbance, irritability, depressed mood may relate to physical illness or side effect of any treatment. Obesity or lack of physical exercise and other lifestyle issues, relationship difficulties or occupational or financial stresses, they all can give a typical symptom. You got it? Means patients have lethargy, fatigue, and so these all can be either obesity, financial stresses, interpersonal issues. Some other B12, simple B12 deficiency, vitamin D deficiency. So we cannot simply attribute all this only to testosterone. So here comes the significance of both biochemical as well as clinical. If both you are getting, go for it, right away. In 50 plus age group, if you are getting even a subnormal testosterone, I mean to say level of 300, 350 and all the symptoms, go for it, give a try, there is no problem. Only the young men whose family is not completed, here you have to be a bit calculated. Low testosterone concentration are especially prevalent among